mysterious is said to roam the uncharted forests of the Pacific Northwest. A creature thought by many to be more closer to man than animal. A creature of superhuman strength and agility, able to crush a small bunny in the palm of its hand. Halfway around the world, in the vast regions of the Himalayas, a similar creature is also rumored to reside. A ghastly beast that continues to terrorize residents, often leaving enormous footprints in the snow. Until today, the most intriguing evidence of the existence of such a creature has been this 1967 footage from Bluff Creek, California. Plaster casts reveal the enormous size and weight of the beast. Is this the evasive missing link called Bigfoot by many, Yeti and Sasquatch by others? Our investigation begins here, in Burbank, California. Located just north of Los Angeles, one might find this an unlikely place for Bigfoot to make an appearance. Known worldwide as a center for music, television, and film production, Burbank is home to some of the biggest and best production studios on the planet. Aside from the glamour of show business, Burbank is also a very peaceful residential community, one of the last remaining towns that feels comfortable leaving its doors unlocked. But lately, the doors have been locked and the peace has been shattered by something horrible that many believe has descended from Burbank's local hills and mountains. Is it possible that a disoriented Sasquatch roaming from the dense mountains of Northern California has found its way and taken refuge in Southern California? It was here, at Johnny Carson Park, on October 31st, 1997, that the most undeniable and astounding evidence was captured. Most scientists agree that with the revolution in video camera technology, it was just a matter of time before someone captured the mysterious beast on tape. The identity of the witness has been obscured and withheld. We will call Edward Mount Mr. Red.
Well, this story is something else, so I'll just start from the very beginning. I like to videotape birds and other various wildlife in California. And, well, Johnny Carson Park gives me the opportunity to indulge in my hobbies. So that's exactly what I was doing that day. I was walking around and videotaping yellow-bellied sapsuckers, blue jays, and other various types of creatures. I was having a wonderful time. And then I came upon this path. And then all of a sudden, I was overwhelmed with this horrible odor. It was as if a park vagrant had wandered down into the shrubs and soiled himself. It was absolutely horrible. It drove me to the point of almost sickness, and I said, hey, I'm gonna get out of here. So I thought nothing of it and investigated it no further. Well, I continued on my way up the path, turned around, and decided to videotape some of the treetops. And I was experiencing a little technical difficulty with my camera, but that's besides the point. It was at that moment it happened. It wandered into my viewfinder. It was incredible and horrifying at the same time. This thing towered at probably 8.5 feet, and it must have at least weighed about 600 pounds. And I was so taken by this creature, and then it took off. This thing had incredible speed. And the crazy thing is that I pursued it. I started chasing this thing, videotaping it, running, chasing it, feeling as if I had to document this for the scientific community. I didn't think about what I was going to do once I caught up with this thing, but, well, just watch the video. It speaks 1,000 words.
What you're about to see is the actual footage recorded by Mr. Red. Please be advised that the images are disturbing and may not be suitable for younger viewers.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Sasquatch.
When compared to the amazing 1967 Bluff Creek 16mm film, striking similarities in weight, height, and stride are evident. The major difference between the two is that here the hairy biped beast walks swiftly and calmly, unaffected by nearby onlookers. At Carson Park, the creature took off at high speed when spotting Mr. Red. So is this video proof of the creature's existence? It is undoubtedly clear that Mr. Red believes what he saw was Bigfoot. It is also evident that if this footage is fake, then it is the product of a well-planned and elaborate hoax forged by top makeup and film professionals who had the funding and skill to create such an elaborate production. If found to be staged, this footage would go down in history with the alien autopsy tape, the War of the Worlds broadcast, and the sinking of the Titanic as the greatest hoaxes of the 20th century. Even skeptics find it hard to overlook the eerily similar features to the creature caught on film in 1967. Dr. Nic Balitas is at the forefront of what researchers call Bigfootology. Facing criticism from his friends, family, and anthropological peers, Dr. Balitas has devoted his life to the study of Bigfoot. His analysis of the Carson Park footage has been vital to the dismissal of it being a hoax.
Although the Carson Park beast captured on Mr. Red's video is very similar to the one captured on film in 1967, I believe this Burbank Sasquatch may in fact be a new breed of Bigfoot.
Well, once all the excitement, the commotion of the whole experience, you know, the adrenaline rush of me chasing after this thing, videoing it, once that all subsided, I pursued the thing as far as I could, until it disappeared into the sewer system. Once I collected my thoughts, it had occurred to me that not since man had first set foot on the moon had something so monumental been captured on video. And there it was, the palm of my hand. Then I tripped over something. Not realizing what it was at first, I got my video camera. And there it was, right in front of me, fresh impressions left in the ground. They were Sasquatch impressions. They were like craters, giant craters of the earth. The size of these things, I mean, the immensity, I can't even... You see this foot right here? Now multiply this by a factor of 10, and you're not even close to the size of these things. I'm telling you, it was a big foot.
This is a plaster cast of the footprint left at Carson Park. Although large when compared to that of a human foot size, I have concluded that this impression was left by a juvenile yeti. When inspecting the print's depth, one can easily see that this creature is of considerable weight. No human of that mass and size can move with the agility and speed captured on the Carson Park video.
Our investigation sent its own team into the Carson Park sewer. We captured this startling audio recording. Mr. Red is not the only witness to the hairy creature. Derek Fry, who we refer to as Mr. X, also encountered the colossal monstrosity. The horrifying events that happened that night, I find very difficult to explain. This was perhaps the most traumatic experience of my life. It was a Friday evening, and I was planning on spending it like any other Friday evening, with my wine glasses. I was hoping that tonight would be the greatest performance of my entire life. But little did I know that just a few feet away, something horrible, something wretched was peering at me in the bushes. This thing, its red eyes glowed and it stared at me and...
I'm sorry, but this thing invaded my privacy and I don't know what to do. I turned the camera off, please.
Thank you. That damn monster walked into my life and he has turned my life upside down. I will never be the same again. All I do is pop pills and see shrinks all day, and worst of all, I will never perform again.
These are fur and feces samples found around the area of Mr. X's reported sighting. Compound analysis of the fur and droppings found metabolic enzymes of unspecified biological origin. What I found interesting is that these samples possess characteristics found in two separate species, man and primate. Take, for example, this sample of Sasquatch poopy. Very similar to man, but much darker and thicker.
In an amazing turn of events, our program was approached by an individual who claims to be the Bigfoot depicted in the Carson Park video. In an effort to shed light on his own existence, we have been allowed to present his exclusive testimony.
Bigfoot not bad. Bigfoot think city lights pretty. Sometimes me get confused and scared. Bigfoot walk in park. Man point strange object and run after Bigfoot. Bigfoot hide in stinky sewer until he hear pretty noise. Sound make Yeti giggle and want to dance. Man stops pretty noise and screams. Bigfoot run to hill. Cry all night. Bigfoot gentle creature, me you no harm. You are very violent. Make me very angry.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
So does Bigfoot really exist? Is he currently lurking in the shadows of Burbank, California? Will he inflict pain on humans who cross his path? Will the children ever feel safe to play outside again? What does Bigfoot eat? Does his family miss him? Is music the universal language?
You saw the video. It's the God's honest truth. The Yetis? They're moving to Burbank.
With all this evidence we have seen today, video, audio tape, droppings, fur, it is my scientific opinion that a Bigfoot has definitely graced the hills of Burbank, California. Thank you.
As our investigation continues, perhaps new findings will enable the community of Burbank to live in harmony with its new neighbor. Until that day, we can only speculate as to the intention of this evolutionary enigma. Bigfoot. Fact or fiction? You decide.